Britain's HMS Hermes, which was laid down on the 15th of January 1918, was the world's first ship to be designed as an aircraft carrier. Around 100 years have passed since then, and aircraft carriers are still being built. Tactical need to carry a fleet of aircraft to project power far beyond the homeland has kept them relevant. Aircraft carriers have also been able to absorb new technologies and adapt themselves to the modern war theater. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes 5 aircraft carriers that are currently being constructed. Let's get started. India is currently operating INS Vikramaditya, which is a modified Kiev-class aircraft carrier that entered into service with the Indian Navy in 2013. INS Vikrant is India's first indigenously constructed aircraft carrier. This is part of India's plan to acquire 3 aircraft carriers in the long run. Vikrant began construction in 2008 at the Cochin shipyard, and due to some delays, the timeline for commissioning has been pushed back to 2020. Vikrant will be 860 feet long with a flight deck width of 203 feet. Like India's flagship INS Vikramaditya, Vikrant will sport a ski ramp for assisted takeoffs and arrestor cables for landing aircraft. It will displace about 45,000 tons and will carry around 35 aircraft. This will include 25 MiG-29K multi-role fighter jets and 10 helicopters. The Queen Elizabeth class is a class of 2 aircraft carriers of the United Kingdom's Royal Navy. HMS Queen Elizabeth, the lead ship of this class, has been commissioned in 2017, and its initial operating capability is expected in 2018. The second, HMS Prince of Wales, is under construction and scheduled for commissioning in 2020. Construction of Prince of Wales has begun in 2011 at Rosyth Dockyard, Scotland. Prince of Wales is very identical to Queen Elizabeth, with both ships being 920 feet long with a flight deck width of 240 feet. The UK's carriers will both displace around 65,000 tons and will have around 1,600 personnel on board. Prince of Wales will generally carry 24 F-35B fighters as well as 14 Merlin anti-submarine and utility helicopters. But in wartime, the carrier could carry up to 36 fighters. China's first carrier, Liao Ning, entered service with the People's Liberation Army Navy in September 2012. The Type 001A, China's second aircraft carrier developed based on Liao Ning, is currently undergoing sea trials. Type 002 will be a major upgrade to both of these carriers. The ship is expected to be launched in 2020 and enter active service in 2023. The vessel is expected to have a displacement of 80,000 tons. Shrouded in secrecy, little is known about the Type 002. The Type 002 is not expected to be nuclear-powered, as China still has some way to go in developing a reactor suitable for large surface ships. Unlike the previous 2 carriers, which employ ski-jump takeoff ramp, the Type 002 may use electromagnetic catapults. As per some reports, China has made some progress in developing means to power electromagnetic catapults using conventional power. Type 002 is estimated to have the capacity to accommodate about 40 jet fighters, such as the Shenyang J-15, helicopters, transport planes, and AEWC aircraft. Ford-class supercarriers will slowly be replacing the Nimitz-class carriers. U.S. Navy is expected to order 12 Ford-class carriers over the next 30 years. USS Gerald R. Ford is the first ship of the Ford class. USS John F. Kennedy, CVN 79, is the second vessel of the Ford class. USS John F. Kennedy was laid down in August 2015 and is 50% complete as of now. It's expected to be commissioned in 2020. It's 1,092 feet long with a flight deck width of about 256 feet. To give viewers a perspective, it's about 3 football fields long. The supercarrier will displace about 100,000 tons when fully loaded. Like other vessels of Ford class, USS John F. Kennedy has newly designed reactors. two Bechtel A-1B nuclear reactors will be installed on USS John F. Kennedy. Each one of these are capable of producing 300 megawatts of electricity, triple the 100 megawatts of each Nimitz-class vessel. The huge power supply provides for the legroom required for future expansions, like including laser guns and electromagnetic railguns. The aircraft carrier will be able to deploy around 75 fixed-winged manned aircraft, unmanned aerial vehicles, and helicopters. It will also house around 4,500 personnel. USS Enterprise, CVN-80, the third Ford-class ship, will enter service in 2027. Interestingly, USS Enterprise will incorporate lessons learned from USS Gerald R. Ford and USS John F. Kennedy. This will be the ninth United States naval vessel to bear the name. CVN-80 will be built by Huntington Ingalls Industries Newport News Shipbuilding in Newport News, Virginia. The ship is currently scheduled to replace USS Dwight D. Eisenhower, CVN-69. The first cut of steel ceremony, marking the beginning of fabrication of the ship's components, was held on the 21st of August, 2017, with ship sponsors Katie Ledecky and Simone Biles present.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.